to have the spots for always. Dottie saw him coming along, and he pulled his whiskers and thought of a joke. He knew that measles had spots, so he called out after the goblin. "Hello, measles! How are your spots?" The goblin turned round and glared at him. "If you dare to say that again, I'll put a spell into your ears," he said. Dottie didn't believe him. He teased him again. "Hello, measles! How are your spots?" Then he quickly rushed off to his hole, laughing happily. The goblin ran back to his oak tree angrily. Then he chanted in an angry voice, "Kiki, Mooney, Billy, Moona. For rabbit's ears. Bottle didn't know it. The spell worked. When Bottle got to his hole and tried to flatten his ears down over his head, as all rabbits must do when they run underground, Bottle found that he couldn't put his ears down at all. Oh no! What happened? They just stayed upright. It was queer. He tried and tried to force his way into the hole. His mother saw him and spoke to him sharply.
"You have left your ears up. Put them down, silly child."
"I can't," said Bottle in dismay.
"Don't be stupid,"
said his mother.
"What have you been to get your ears like this?"
I was rude to the spotted goblin," said Bottle, looking ashamed. "I said, 'Hello, measles. How are your spots?'"
"What? You are as rude as that? I'm ashamed of you. You deserve to have a spell put into your ears. You really do."
"This is dreadful. What shall I do?" thought the Bobtail. "I never knew before how important it is for rabbit's ears to be able to flop over." From that day onwards, Bobtail was very sad. He regretted what he had done. How he wished his ears were back to normal. One day, as he was walking back to his burrow, he saw the spotted goblin standing at the top of a steep hill. Bottle made his way humbly to him. "Please, spotted goblin," he said, "I'm very sorry I was rude to you. Take this spell out of my ears. I'll never be rude to anyone again." "You deserve it. Go away," said the goblin. "Please, spotted goblin, please help me," begged Bottle again. "Yours. Tell me, please," begged Bobtail. "All right, I'll tell you. Now, listen carefully. The only way to break the spell is to throw you from the top of the hill to the bottom." "Oh no, oh no," cried Bobtail, wishing he had never gone near the goblin. The goblin lunged out his foot and gave Bobtail a hard kick. "Down you go." Bobtail rolled down the hill, over and over, over and over, head and back, and heels and ears and tail, over and over. His ears were bent and he squealed in pain. "Help me! Help me!" he screamed. He lost two whiskers. He hurt his foot. He bruised his bobtail. And he suddenly bent his ears till they nearly broke. "Ouch!" he sat up, feeling very shaky at the bottom of the hill. He felt himself all over to see if he was still there. Two young rabbits came out to look at him.
"Do you usually come down the hill like that?"
bend themselves down when I went into the hole.
I'm showing you a pattern of your rudeness now,
said his mother. Mother, I will be the most polite rabbit there ever was, said Bob Tail.
What a change,
said his mother. And it certainly was. Bob Tail has learned his lesson well. Friends, we must be polite to everyone, whether they are young,